Boom. Hello, replay viewers. It's been a strange summer, but I'm finally, boat's fixed, and I'm finally underway, southbound, slowly. Hey, Lindsay. This is going to be a little tricky scope, because the interesting things to see are in this direction, which is looking into the sun. This is one of my favorite parts of this area, parts of the whole trip, actually. Because often I'm coming from the Boston area, and then I get into, good morning, Greg, I get into the Gloucester Harbor, and then I do the little canal and the river here, and there's about an hour and a half of peace and quiet. In the spring especially, the conditions aren't always as nice as I'd like them to be. But today, all the hurricanes are gone. There's no hurricane swell. Let's look this way. Yep, the motor's going to sound a little bit slightly different. I have a new propeller, which is which turned out to be quite a project. So this is, we tested it in the river. And today is its first day of actually going somewhere. So I did have a bit of luck. The tide started to go out, so I got a push out, but now it's still going out. And I have quite a ways to go in this river with the tide running out. So a couple miles, and then I'll get to the train bridge and the highway bridge, and then the current changes. So the difference in the old propeller and the new propeller, there shouldn't be any difference in performance. The difference is the old propeller was it had a mechanical system, so if you were in forwards it would work, and if you went into neutral the blades would rotate and act and feather and sort of just slide gently. They'd turn horizontally, so they just slide through the water with no resistance. And then if you went into reverse, the blades would turn the other direction and engage reverse that way. So a lot of people pay money for these things, thinking they're getting, and they probably do get slightly better performance if they're sailing because the blades feather. But the penalty you pay is mechanical. And if that propeller ever had a mishap, now you're literally up the creek without a paddle, so to speak. So I really didn't want to have that as a weak point since I use the motor so much. Hey, we're getting a good view in this direction. I'm happy. And I'm able to see. I'm kind of sticking my head around, trying to look for the next buoy. So this mechanical propeller is good if you're in range of help. But if it ever gives out, then you've basically your boat's disabled. If that propeller had any trouble, I do have a spare that came with the boat in 1994. The original propeller's here, and it was put on during this whole propeller process. It was put on and tested, and the goal of having a correct propeller will let your engine run at wide open throttle at the specification the engine manufacturer designates for that engine. So if you have a propeller that is too aggressive in trying to move you forwards, then your engines run slow and the cylinders coke up and black smoke comes out the back. So all kinds of bad things. Oh, here's a little houseboat. I'm not near it. You can figure out what we're looking at. This is a nice view over here. With the low, the sun's been up for just a couple hours. When I come through here in the spring, there were zero boats. And you can see there's still more moorings than boats, so some people didn't put their boat in, or it's getting so late in the year, they've taken it out. I do have to pay a little bit of attention up ahead. This is a very, not everybody likes to go through here. It can get shallow in a few spots. They dredged last winter, and they're going to come back and finish dredging this winter. So the worst of the shallow places have been taken out. 12 months ago when I came through here, I was up a little farther ahead. Thank you for the pink hearts. and it has a little farther ahead, and it's low tide, of course, and I've never had trouble before with low tide, but I said, why are those boats anchored up there, those motorboats, which don't draw much water, why are those motorboats anchored up there? Well, guess what? They're anchored up there because they run aground. And guess what? I ran aground. but it was low tide, and the tide was rising, and that put... I wasn't going much farther than Roy. I ran aground, so it was all okay. There was just a bit of a delay. Now I've got to go back to the wheel because there's some more movement coming up. This must be some kind of a crab boat. It has a pot hauler on it. There's not much in the way of lobster here. The lobsters have all died out on Long Island, much farther south. And I don't see too many lobster pots in the water. I saw a couple coming across. So I grew up around here. I love the marsh. When the tide is quite low, the mud gets exposed. And for someone that grew up around it, the smell is so invigorating. Just a lovely way of knowing that you're at home. So the tide here is 10 to 12 feet. For you non-US people, that's about 3.5 to 4 meters. Depending on what the moon is doing. So if you head here on the right, it's kind of a shallow creek. And there's always a couple houseboats planted in there. And the owners must have gift to come and hang out when it's hot in the summertime. So going along in here is pretty easy with all these boats and moorings. I just go down through the middle. But then we're coming up to a sharp turn where there's a bit of a shallow area. But the tide isn't low, it's about halfway out. So I'm not worried. It seems like more often than not I come through here with dead low tide. But having this place having been dredged for the first time in decades, it's all good. The only trouble is with the tide running out. Oh, there's my death alarm going off. Quiet. With the tide, it's just that comment, so I'm paying attention. Yeah, it is. It's very beautiful here. With the tide going out, it slows me down. I'm off course. Okay. Yeah. So my GPS is showing 4.8 knots. And I should be doing 6.5. There's about 1.5 knots of current. There is the option of going around the typical band. But this is, where I'm going to end up tonight, it doesn't really make a difference to worry about even 30 minutes if I went one way versus the other. I'm not quite sure where I'm going to end up. I know where I want to end up, but then I may be able to go longer. By the way, that's a little cute little cat boat, and it says it's for sale. So who wants a sweet little cat boat? I'll go back and get you the number. So this I'm going to stand over here to get a better view. This channel is marked by kind of a combination. Honeypot, do you want a cat boat? Do you still computer work? No, I haven't done any computer work for a little while. So this river is marked mostly by floating buoys, but ages ago, and I don't know how long ago, but decades ago. Yes, go back. All right, well, we'll get you a cat boat. The only trouble is you'll have to keep it somewhere. There's also these steel casings that they drove into the mud, and I presume filled with rocks or concrete. The only trouble with these things is if the silt's in there, you can't move them. You can also see, I hope you can see, the tide's about half out. You can see the top part is rusty and the bottom part is full of barnacles. It's about a half tide. Yeah, this must be some kind of service boat because it's all these giant fenders on the side. Better really pay attention. So coming up to a turn. Of course, we're not not going any high kind of high speed. But you can see why some people are scared of this place. It's narrow and there are rocks. It's an interesting combination of the marsh. And if I put my Boston accent on, the marsh and rocks. So here's number 21. The numbers go up as you go upstream. In this part of the world, you keep the greens on the left and the reds on the right as you're returning. And in Europe, you keep them the other way around. So it takes a little bit of getting used to. I don't know how well you can see these homes against the sun, but they're very, very pricey. You're not going to find any cheap homes here like you would in Missouri. These are all seven figures for these small ones. Up ahead, we're going to go around quite a mansion. That's a good strike. Yeah, I'm just chugging along, 5 knots, spread up a little bit. Got to watch the bottom. I know they dread sea. I used to, I'm coming up with a green buoy, which is supposed to leave on the port side. And I used to always cut it on the wrong side, shallow. And you can even see how shallow it was. But I think this is where one of the sections the dredge took care of. So now I'm going to pay attention and pass this buoy correctly, but barely correctly. A little bit of concentration here. Because the current is pouring out, and I'm making small corrections from steering. Don't want to hit the thing. And then I make a sharp turn this way. Welcome to my island, Florida. Greg, I am heading to Florida. This is day one. Yeah! Going on to Florida, one day at a time. So there was a long delay because the propeller project took way longer than it should have. But that was okay. Come to, I don't know the countries, I don't know those flags. Somebody help me with what flag that is. And the other delay was there was a huge, huge pile of hurricanes coming off of Africa and going toward Puerto Rico. Coming up, who knows where they were coming up to. So today is the first day in I don't know, eight weeks or something, that there's no sign of any trouble on the hurricane map. Finally. Well, there's a shallow line again. I'm going to pay attention to this side. I can't watch the screen as much as I'd like to. I shouldn't get too close to that red. You can, over here, you can start to see the mud starting to get exposed. Oh, the Netherlands, of course! I discovered on YouTube a channel about biking in the Netherlands. And, oh my goodness, I liked the idea of the Netherlands before, but having seen those biking videos, oh my goodness, I'm so excited, I'm a crazy person. I really would like to visit there. I have had a friend, a very good friend, and she dropped out of sight. I'd like to go and see if I can find out what's happened. I'd have to play detective. And it's so cool to bike around in the Netherlands. Okay, the giraffe is not this month, that's for sure. And it might not even be next month. We'll have to see how Mother Nature, how nice that Mother Nature is. In terms of letting me make some progress. So the short term is like, looks like the next couple days are nice, and then we'll see. Hi Jen. Are you in between clients, Jen? A lot of people like this kind of living arrangement, but I don't think I'd want to have neighbors so close. And the other thing is, remember how I was saying how these are seven-figure houses, the price? A lot of these houses are only used in the summertime. And I would guess, you know, maybe the main family is here in the summer, and the person that's the high-paid breadwinner comes on the weekend. We're very close to a train station, so easy to get into Boston on the train. But that's where you're working. Here's another one. And I don't know who Roberti is, but it looks like a political advertisement. So these houseboats seem to be growing somewhat. There were only two in the creek. Usually there's three or four. But there's more here. And this is an interesting boat. It's tied at both ends, so it doesn't swing into the shallows, presumably. I've got to pay a little more attention. I don't want to hit the rocks. That would spoil the day. So a little farther ahead, I'm going to go under the Route 128 highway bridge. And then around the corner and down the stretch, there's the Amtrak bridge. They're replacing it with the plan changed, but they're building two bridges instead of one. The idea was they'd keep half of the old one operational, but that didn't work out. But the plan has already been developed. So they're going to build two bridges, one track each, so people can get to from Rockport and Gloucester. And you might hear a little bit of radio traffic. There's two bridges. The first is the Amtrak bridge, the train bridge. And then there's the Blumen bridge. And I did this scope once before. And when I went through the train bridge, I was completely surrounded by the timbers of the bridge and got cut off. So that might be the unexpected termination of part one. If this was low tide, I'd be a lot more nervous. I should be paying more attention to the depth sounder than I am. Because this is another shallow section right here. Oh, it's lovely. This is one reason I like coming through here. I see so much open ocean. Here's a sharp turn. This is just so lovely. Alright, there we go. I don't have to turn so much. So I've come through here at low tide. At low tide, it's actually better to come through here. If you're worried about hitting, it's better to come through at low tide, because then you can see whether the water changes color from a bluish to a green, and that's the sand or the shallows. And if you come through at low tide and get stuck, then it's not long before you get unstuck. But if you had trouble at a higher tide, then you kind of could be doomed for a long delay. All right, get a little attention. Yeah, I know. I think that it's counterintuitive. You know, you would think that, oh, don't get too close to shore because there's rocks. But sometimes it's deep right along the edge, oddly enough. So I'm showing 12 feet, and the tide's going to drop another 5 or so. So it's fairly safe here. I think green. Oh, do I have a green coming up? No, I have the bridge next. There's a red. Yeah, there we go. So right along the edge. And you see the moss is showing. The kelp. Gonna head for the center of the bridge. This is a bridge you don't want to be off course on, because it's so it curves downward quite rapidly. So all the bridges here, they have a green light in the center and red light on either side, showing where you're supposed to pass between. So at night, you know where to go. Yeah, okay. at that red buoy. Let's see, there's a green up ahead. So this is another reason bigger sailboats won't come through, because first they're worried about running aground. That issue's going to be resolved by dredging, but they also might have a mast that's too tall to fit. And it always looks worse than it is. It always looks like you're going to have a bad accident, when in fact, there's plenty of space. Now, wouldn't it be funny if I had a bad accident? But no, I've been through here. I've been through here many times, and it's all fine. So, looks low, but it's okay. We'll have 10 seconds of shade. I have my jacket up because I'm covering up the microphone. Yep, no accident, no mishap. Everything's good. This is a little tricky section up here, which also got helped by the dredge. This is up, just a little bit up ahead is where I got stuck a year ago. Very, very tight spot. So you're never quite sure exactly where the dredge has been, and how thorough of a job they did. You know, if they missed a spot. You would think somebody would go through after they finish to see if they did the proper job. But you know, if they didn't do the proper job and they finished and they're taking all their stuff away, and now it's too late. What are they going to do? But this dredge contract is for 2 years, so they're going to come back and finish up a few spots they didn't get to last winter. All right. Once I'm around the corner up here, then I'm going to have to change my radio a little bit. I have it on scan. It's on channel 16, in case anybody's calling me, which is highly unlikely. And it's on channel 13 for people calling for the bridges. I was hoping to hear somebody call for the train bridge, but train bridge only needs to open for sailboats. The other bridge has to open for everybody, except the very small skiff. So when I was here last spring, the train bridge had opened, and then when I got up to it, it was broken. So you never know what state something's going to be in. And I would hate to have to go back and go around. That would upset me. So this is the section. I ran aground before I got to this thing last year. And now it's been fixed up. It's nice and deep. I know I can cut over here. Cut over here quite a bit. Don't hesitate. I can almost go right up to this dock. And actually, in the past, in the spring, when that dock's not there, I've gone over that first spot. So I know it's deep there. Then we're going to be seeing the Amtrak Bridge. I wish in my other boat, I could mount this camera phone on a stand. But this boat is so enclosed, that's not an option. So I really need to operate the radio myself. And once I get going straight, I'll put the autopilot on. I've been steering with one hand and holding the phone with the other. I was going to say entertaining with the other hand, but I don't think that would be correct. So here's an estate. This is a spiffy spot. A little summer house. And naturally, there's somebody coming. I can't go on autopilot quite yet. I'm going to be quiet for a minute. I'm paying attention. Yep, give me plenty of space. This is narrow here. There's more water than depth. Let's see if they'll wave. Right. Get a little bit straightened out. Autopilot's on. Look somewhere. You take the scanner off. I'm on the bridge frequency now, exclusively. And I should column. I don't know if it's up or down or if the thing is even still there. Got to make sure I don't go wrong here on the autopilot. Take the autopilot off for a minute. So I can't tell if this buoy in front of me is a red or a green. I think it's a green.
Let's hope it's a green.
Amtrak Bridge, Amtrak Bridge. Good morning, southbound sailboat. The bridge might be demolished at this point. I really can't tell, there's so much construction. I don't look like a fool calling for a bridge that's demolished. Let's get up to find out. Just getting back behind the wheel. So I can operate the controls. You can see it's difficult to see ahead here at this point. So I keep having to duck over a little bit. The other interesting thing about this bridge is it makes a 90-degree turn, and you can't see who's coming, or if anybody's coming. So I've heard stories that on the weekend, people will bring their lawn chair and a cooler full of beer, and they'll sit and watch the accidents. And they're not every 5 minutes, but I would think there's a boat ramp here, too, if people want to go from one side to the other along this river. So I wouldn't be surprised if there are accidents fairly frequently. Nothing serious, but bumping. All right, let's see what the story is. Can I get through it? Might have to hold it up. I'm gonna slow down a little bit. So I can't give room to any of these little motorboats. They're gonna have to. There's more motorboats coming, they have to look out for me. So I can't do anything about that. Yep, no bridge. First time in my whole life, no bridge. Nice. Speed up, otherwise you're going to get hit. Might get cut off here. That was the harbor master boat going by. Let's see if we get cut off.